O shodi o shodi o shodi o shodi o shodi o. Ano pacha kecha gondo, ano pacha kecha gondo. Enta enta wole pelu change, wole pelu change. So everyone wants to drive a Ferrari, everyone wants to drive a Lamborghini, everyone wants to drive an Aston Martin. We all want to cruise that very, very lovely car. But you cannot without your license. Yeah, because license is very, very important in everywhere you go. License can stand as your government ID, can stand as so many things, which is why it is very, very relevant. If that is why you came here, just stick to the video, subscribe, and just definitely keep on watching. Let's get right in. As we all know, the topic is about getting your license, and getting license differs in different type of countries. Some countries, they don't even take tests to get your license. But here in Canada, in North America, yeah, you have to take tests, and not just one test, you have to take knowledge test, and you also have to take road test. So I'm going to be giving you guys detailed explanation to make your dreams come true. Driving the Aston Martin, driving the Ferrari, driving most expensive Toyota, driving any type of car cannot be possible here without your driver's license. So, and there are so many stages, there are so many obstacles and stages you need to cross before you get the license. And I'm also going to be showing you and doing like a small unboxing of the license I got and explaining the type of license I got. Coming to Canada, there are three good stages of license that you are to get, or that you are to pass through. You pass the first stage, second, and you get to the last stage before you can get the full license of any province. You already have their own type of license. So the first type of license on the list is what we call the 5L. It is a learner's license. The L stands for learners, and it is a learner's license, which is the beginner stage for anybody who doesn't know how to drive, for people who have not even touched steering before or even started ignition before. Your best bet, your best category is the 5L. The 5L, before you get the 5L, you have to pass through some little stages. You have to take a knowledge test. Knowledge test is going to be an online based knowledge test, which you have to practice for either by getting the manual or by studying it online, doing quizzes and downloading the manual online if you want to. Okay, the learner's based test, you have to get some requirements before you can even register as a customer for the particular insurance company that is going to book the test, or for the particular agency or whichever means that you want to use to book your test. When you book the test, you go take your exam. It can be either a paper exam or it can be online. For the province of Manitoba, you are going to be given 30 questions. You must not fail more than 6 questions to pass the test. If you fail more than 6 questions, you will be asked to return after 7 days to take your test. So after you pass your knowledge test, you are going to go for the vision test, but then to make sure you just see well, you're actually seeing very well on the road, so you're not going to hit someone. So after the vision test, then you pay some licensing fee and you get your 5L license given to you. The learner's license stage takes about 9 months. Disadvantages of learner's license: learner's license, you cannot drive alone. You have to drive like a learner. Even if you are an expert coming from your home country, you have to be a learner for 9 months. And while you are a learner, you cannot drive alone. Even if you have a car, you have to drive with someone. For Manitoba, you have to drive with someone who has a full license, and not only a full license, someone who has been driving with the full license for up to 3 years. Okay, so if you are able to succeed that obstacle, then after your 9 months, you now go for the road test. Now guys, this is the hardest part of the whole scenario. I know someone who has done road test for 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 for 8 good times. The person did road test and kept on failing and failing. It is not that difficult, but when you put up fear in you, when you put up the fear that you're going to be given a bad instructor, when you put up the fear that you might make mistakes in your turning signals, in your 3 points turn, your parallel parking, my brother, you are on your way to failure. You just have to summon the courage. Okay, when you take the road test, you'll be put up with an instructor who will guide you, and the road test consists about 15 minutes to 20 minutes and you are done. Yeah, you are done. So after the road test and you pass, you'll be given the what do they call that one? The intermediate 5I. That is the next stage we are going to now. After your road test, you will be given the 5I, which is the intermediate license. Now, for this intermediate, you can now drive like a madman. You can drive like anyhow you want to want. If you want to do Fast and Furious with your license, drive. But there is also a restriction. Nothing goes for nothing. Everything cannot be free, my G. No, it doesn't work that way. There are also restrictions to the 5I. But the 5I, the restriction is kind of complicated. But honestly, when you get your 5I, just close your mind. You are already on your way to full license. They are just going to put some small salt and pepper so that you'll be scared that you cannot drive with your 5I just like you would do with your 5F, which is the full license. But honestly, your 5I is a replica of your 5F. You don't need to be scared. And when, if you guys are confused with the numbers I'm calling 5I, it means class 5. Class 5 learners, class 5 intermediate, and your class 5 full license. 5L, 5I, 5F. You will not, from the period of 12 a.m. to like 4 a.m., you should not carry people more than the seat belt in your car. That is a story. You know, it's a story. We all know how those ones work. They will just put the thing so that you'll be like, ah, please do this. So that is for 5I. And the 5I is the duration of 15 months. It's so scary, which is 1 year and 3 months. But I always tell people, you don't have to mind the duration. The duration really does not matter. The basic thing is, you're getting your license and you're driving alone without anybody monitoring. Okay? Am I making sense? If I'm making sense, don't forget to subscribe. If you have any questions about the license, let me know in the comment section. If you want to ask more questions about the learner stage, the intermediate stage, let me know in the comment section. Now let's move on. Oh my god, I said section. Sorry, section. Now let's move on to the next stage, which is the last and the final stage, is the class 5F, the class 5 full license. The full license, now when you won't be Vin Diesel, you can claim Vin Diesel with your 5F. Drive as far as New York. Nobody will hold you. Nobody will stop you. Drive as far as British Columbia, Toronto, go to the Northwest Territories, go to Nunavut, go to... Now, I'm going to be telling you the type of license I got and the reason why I got that license. If you guys are going to hear from me, it's really going to be sad because you all know from Nigeria, I was an expat. I was part, and if you watch my driving vlog, which I'm going to leave a link below in the description. If you watch my driving vlog, you're going to see that your boy was an expat. No, not the driving vlog. Sorry. When I was in Nigeria, yeah. I was an expat, but here... If you hear the license I got, you'll be shocked. If you still want to know the license I got, definitely keep on watching. Subscribe below, comment section. Let us interact. Let us kajoma sorrow. Let us sorrow. Let's talk. This is a one-on-one. Like, this is a one-on-one. This is not just me talking and everything. When I give you the information, if you still have things you want to clarify, you let me know. I'm always open for you. Okay. Now, guys, I already did a pre-unboxing. I was like, I wanted to confirm if it was mine. So when I saw it in the mailbox, I was like, quickly open it. So don't mind the whole tearing stuff. It is still in package. Yeah, this is it here. And I'll be showing you shortly. So after I passed my knowledge test and I paid the whole license fee, they told me, okay, I was going to receive it within two to three weeks. And it came just in 2 weeks and a day or so, thereabout. So I got the license and here it is. It says here the Manitoba driver's license, blah blah blah, with family and everything. So the license is here is the license. Yeah, so this is it. And this is a note I got. Yeah, story telling me why this license is this and why that is that. Security feature of the license. So guys, your favorite boy got 5L. I know he's sad. I got a learner's I got a learner's license, guys, and I know it is going to be quite shocking to some people who are going to watch this video and be like, ah, Frank, that used to drive me to Yanokpaja, Oshodi, to Jebode, and all those places. How did you get the learner's license? But guys, the thing is, I didn't bring my license from my home country. That is one thing I also want to advise you guys and chip in this video. If you're coming from your home country, be it Nigeria, Ghana, Kenya, Bangladesh, India, wherever in the world, you should have your home country license. If you get your home country license, you are going to skip the 5L and the 5I, which is the learners and the intermediates. You will still take knowledge tests. You're still going to take your knowledge test and you're still going to take your road tests. But you're not going to wait for 9 months or 15 months for the learners and intermediate stage. You just move straight to the full stage, provided you pass. When you bring your home country license into Canada, you are still allowed to drive for 3 months, 180 days. Abi? Yes. 180 days, 90 days, I don't know, but about 3 months before you can even say you want to switch. So it's not a must. You're coming as a visitor, you're coming for tourism, you're coming as a student, whichever pathway you're using to come to Canada, you can bring your home country license, which will serve you for 3 months. So you don't just rush in and start running to go and get a license. No. You can still drive with your home country license. Okay, am I making sense? If I'm making sense, let me know in the comment section. If I'm not making sense, tell me why I'm not making sense. So I got the 5L because I didn't have enough time to get my license from my home country. And I was like, okay, let my dad bring it for me. But the whole pandemic started. Before my popsy will come, it will reach like maybe end of the year. And your boy cannot wait till end of the year before you have an ID. The second reason I got my license, I had to get the 5L regardless of any fact, was the fact that because I don't want to be taking my passport everywhere I go as a government ID. In Manitoba, whenever they ask you, sorry, can I get your government ID? Is it your license or your passport, your driver's license or your international passport or your Canadian passport, whichever one you have? You cannot use study permit as government issued ID. No, you cannot use your social insurance number proof as your government issued ID. No. So I was like, okay, if I get the license, even if I know how to drive, at least when they ask me for my issued, I can be able to give them this license instead of bringing my passport. The reason why I don't like carrying my passport around is because the passport still has my visa on it. And it's very, very risky carrying my visa. No. I rather keep the passport at home and use this as a government issued ID. Another advantage of this passport, you can use it to travel by plane. I can use this and my study permit and on my way to Mexico. Disclaimer, Mexico is a visa-free country for Canadian students. Yeah, so you guys should come. Let us flex. Come, let us rock the area, okay? Advantage, permit me, because I'm going to be looking down. I have some things that I quickly jotted down. So permit me, one of the advantages is that you can use it to board a plane. The second advantage is that you can be easily identified by the Manitoba government with your driver's license. Those are the advantages of this. Well, the disadvantages of this license is that you cannot use it to cross border by land. There's a particular license, it is called the GDEL, I really don't know, graduated something, advanced enhanced license. That is the one you can use to cross land border. If I want to travel by plane, I can use this, but if I want to travel by road to America, I cannot use this. Take notes. Yeah, so if I want to travel by land, I either use my international passport. Basically, there's really no need to stress the whole thing. You cannot use this because this is just driver's license for Manitoba. It does not give you access to America. And so in order for you guys not to face this whole while I've been discussing and be like, but boy, why are you just talking story up and down? The most advisable thing is for you to get your license from your home country. It's going to cover a whole lot of things for you. It will solve a whole lot of problems for you, honestly speaking. Now the next thing is, if you eventually or unfortunately you didn't get your license and you now come here and say, okay, I want to start from the beginning, I want to get my learner's license, you have to pay, right? The knowledge test costs $10, and forget, the amount is small, but people used to fail it. They fail knowledge test in Canada, I have someone who wrote knowledge test for four times. Have a good time. Like, actually, why are you writing? It's a simple knowledge test. And the road test costs $30. So take note, knowledge test costs $10 for Manitoba, and the road test costs $30. When you go to other provinces, Ontario, they have their own cost for their own license, which is the G1, G2, and the G4 license. When you go to Alberta, they have the Class 7, the Class 5 GDL, and the Class 5 full. When you go to Saskatchewan, they have their own. Go to New Brunswick, Newfoundland and Labrador, Nunavut, Northwest Territories, Prince Edward Island. Anywhere you go, British Columbia, they have their own type of license. But strictly for Manitoba, the knowledge test is $10 and the road test is $30. Like I told you guys, they used to fail it. One Shibiburuku, they fail it. They fail knowledge test here, yeah. And they fail road test here too. If you fail your knowledge test or your road test for a maximum of 4 times, you will be asked to go, Oga, hey Joe, Loshi training, please. You are not fully prepared. When you fail for the first time, you'll be given 7 days ultimatum to prepare and come back again and book. Another thing is when you get your 5L, if you want to take your 5I, you do the road test. But if you want to get your 5F, you don't need to do any road test again. You already passed that road. So that road test is going to cover till you get your full license. So 5L for beginners, 9 months, you'll get your 5I, 15 months, then you get your 5F. If you bring from your home country, when you bring your license from your home country, do your knowledge test, your road test, 5F. Straight up. Yes. Forward ever, backward never. Okay. These are the basic things you used to know, the stages of licensing, what you are required to bring for the licensing. And there's also what they call driver's rating. For your license, if you go and do Oriburuku on the road, your rating is reducing. It's just like when you enter an Uber and your Uber driver drives roughly, you're going to give him a bad rating. So when you are being given a bad rating, your rating score reduces, your insurance for your car is going to increase, and your insurance. I'm going to make a video on the things you can do. Small when you do KKK, Canada will add money. When you do K, they'll add money. Anything they do here is money. Your insurance is going to be getting destroyed. Your driver's rating is going to be getting tampered with. Your drivers, like your assurance that okay, but boy, my boy, your motor, the people are not going to trust you, so they're not going to trust you with your rating. Your money, insurance money for your car is getting expensive. Obviously, you want to get a license and also get a car. License is not for, I didn't just get this license just to use it for, I told you guys I got it for government ID purpose, but I'm on my way to get my car by special grace of God. So that is that for licensing in Canada. So if you have any questions, let me know in the comment section. Available to answer you guys' questions. But basically, this quickly briefed topic of licensing has the basic information you need to know: knowledge test, road test, full license test, every test, and you have your license and you drive your car like you want. So guys, thank you for watching and thank you for stopping by for this video. I will see you in my next video where we pull up. Thank you.